On this week's Waypoint, there are a lot of champion changes to go over. And a lot of champion changes to go over. So let's get started. What's up, guys, and welcome to Waypoint, your weekly League of Legends recap. I'm your host, Kat Andrusco. Let's dive right into Tuesday's 4.21 patch notes. Did I mention that we have a lot of champion changes to go over? Let's start with Cassiopeia. Riot has struggled to find a good spot for Cassie for a long time, and her rework didn't help too much. She's always been a late-game monster, and although her rework pushed that strength, it came at the expense of her early game. Her identity as a poison mage also got a bit lost along the way. Aspect of the Serpent, her stacking passive, has been adjusted in a slightly confusing way. The short story is that she now gains stacks once every 6 seconds, and for every second an enemy champion is poisoned. The special power spikes on the ability have had their cost increased, but because of the new method of stacking is more effective, it's still a buff. Her Q has also been adjusted. There was a bug fix to make sure it's consistently hitting at the same time every time, which is now 0.4 seconds. On top of that, instead of scaling from 10% to 30% move speed as you rank up, it's now a flat 20% at all ranks. Buff to her early game, nerf to her late game, but it'll definitely help her laning phase. Her E is where she's getting her poison mage identity back, in a really big way. Twin Fang now amplifies poison damage by 20% for 5 seconds, which you can stack up to a capped 40% bonus poison damage. That's a big damage boost. Its mana cost has been slightly adjusted as well, costing 5 more at rank 1, but evening out and then decreasing as you rank up. Fiddlesticks has been pretty terrifying in the new jungle, so he's getting a few tweaks. His passive no longer debuffs magic resistance for all enemies within 800 range. Instead, you have to deal magic damage or cast Terrify to lower the target's resistance. I know that's technically a nerf, but it's also kind of a buff, isn't it? Okay, a lot of players aren't going to notice Fiddle's passive when he's in Fog of War. At the higher ranks or in pro play, though, I'd take that trade. Next up, Galio's ultimate no longer has its duration reduced by Tenacity. Awesome. Galio is very unpopular, to say the least, and this is a deceptively powerful buff, in my opinion. Galio has one of the best teamfighting ultimates in the game, but Merc Treads just crushes him, until now. After a short break away from the league, Jax might be on the way back. He dominated top lane throughout a lot of 2014, until eventually getting a big nerf bat to the face. To try and bring him back to a balanced level, Riot has lowered the cooldown of his E, which is his stun. Riot has also given him some free stats with his ultimate, which is nice. Jace has been fixed and buffed, which is code for nerfed and compensated. So before this patch, you would hypercharge, wait a bit, and double hypercharge for ludicrous damage. You can't do that anymore, but Riot were nice enough to take 1 second off its cooldown to make up for it. Unintended and kind of goofy, which I guess is kind of true, to be fair. Kennen is another one of those champions that rocked it Season 2 and hasn't been seen very much since. His W is apparently now more responsive and reliable, which is great. His ultimate has been slightly adjusted to be a bit more effective against multiple targets, but slightly less effective against single targets. It's not a straight tooltip damage nerf or buff, so it's kind of confusing to read. I don't think this means we're going to see more Kennen, though. Nocturne now gains speed when moving towards feared targets. Back in patch 4.3, fear effects across the board were adjusted to make the champion run away from the target. That does make sense thematically, but it was super awkward for Nocturne in particular. This new effect also works against targets that other champions have feared, which isn't going to be a common occurrence, but it's cool. Pantheon has been a very powerful jungler in the preseason with devastating early ganks, which is exactly what his kit is built for. So Riot has decided to confuse all Pantheon players with this patch in the hopes that they don't play him anymore. Seriously, what does this even mean? And I quote, "He completes attacks faster, but doesn't attack faster overall." That's a nerf. Sejuani, otherwise known as Battle Pig, has never been a popular champion. A massive base mana increase and the damage on all her abilities except her ult are being changed and moved around. Riot's goal here was to give her more of a reason to stick around and do stuff in teamfights, instead of just bursting and waiting for your cooldowns. Definitely give her a shot in the new jungle and see how she performs. Shyvana has had the most success in the top lane, shoving lanes over and over and becoming a big tanky dragon. Looks like Riot wants her to make a reappearance in the jungle though. 1 second off the cooldown on her Q, but more importantly, her W, which is her AoE, deals 20% bonus damage to monsters. Hello, crazy jungling speed! Soraka's health regen has been absolutely gutted, which is no surprise whatsoever. She is so annoying to play against with heal after heal on the AD carry in lane. You have to all in the Soraka, but that isn't always possible, and if you can't, you just lose lane, or go even at best. The ability ratio on Astral Blessing's passive has been buffed though, which I like because that works off Star Call, which players should be rewarded for hitting. Warwick nerfs! After hitting an insane 60% win rate, this is no surprise at all. He's lost 4 seconds on the duration of his attack speed buff and taken a massive nerf in ultimate damage. Hopefully that brings him back in line, but I would not be surprised at all if he continues to be very strong. Those are 2 big nerfs though, so we'll have to wait and see. Poor old Zac is getting a little love in this patch, but frankly, Rek'Sai just seems like a better Zac to me. He's getting a damage buff on his elastic slingshot, and it'll also create extra chunks for each champion hit. Also, his ultimate will now knock back enemies a bit further. I hope I'm wrong, but I think Zac needs a lot more love than that to make a comeback. He was really strong at one point, but nerf after nerf has taken its toll on the big green blob. Moving on, Cho'gath hasn't been a big deal since Season 2, even though he has a solid kit. His ultimate's cooldown and mana cost have now reduced by 50% if it kills a minion or a monster. Its base cooldown has been up from 60 seconds to 80 seconds. Hopefully we see a bit more Cho'gath, but I'm not holding my breath. Yasuo probably got hit with the nerf bat a little too hard back in 4.18. Riot has increased his move speed by 5, which is nice, and lowered the cooldown of his Q to 4 seconds at all ranks. There's obviously a lot more minor nerfs, so be sure to check the patch notes. But do you know what's hard to do while playing League of Legends? Reading a book. No, seriously, I tried and I fed like crazy. That's why I use Audible.com. Whether it's in the car, while playing League of Legends, or chilling in bed, Audible is the best way to get your audiobook fix. With great prices, tons of special promotions, and sales for members, Audible offers everything from The Hunger Games to Game of Thrones to Star Wars. There's honestly just something for everyone on Audible.com. If you're interested, head on over to audible.com/gamebreaker and start your free 30-day trial today. And just for signing up, you'll receive a free audiobook that's yours to keep. That URL again is audible.com/gamebreaker. That does it for this week's episode of Waypoint. For more video game news and content, head on over to gamebreaker.tv. Be sure to check back every week for the latest League of Legends news. If you enjoyed this video, please like and comment below and help us reach more people. And if you want more League of Legends content, recaps, and updates, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, LOL Nation TV. I'm Kat Andrusco. You can follow me on Twitter at Kat Andrusco. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you at the next Waypoint. Gamebreaker TV.